Here's a quick GeoGebra demonstration to show you if you have two lines cut by a transversal so that a pair of corresponding angles are congruent, then those two lines are parallel. A quicker way of writing that would be if you have corresponding angles that are congruent, then the lines that created them are parallel. So here I have an angle, and I can change the value of the angle. And if I create a corresponding angle, now, first of all, what is a corresponding angle? A corresponding angle is an angle that is in kind of the same position, but on a different line. In other words, M and N are these two lines cut by a transversal T, and corresponding angles are angles in the same spot. Now, I could say this angle, angle ABC, is kind of in like the northeast quadrant, if we wanted to think about it that way. So northeast quadrant and northeast quadrant. And I see that these two lines, regardless of what the angle is, those two lines will be parallel. So this is a construction of Euclid, and if you wanted to learn a little bit more about that, feel free to ask your teacher or Google around. But basically, the point is, if we have corresponding congruent angles, then lines are parallel. And now we can use that statement in further proofs. Take a minute to read this if-then statement. The if part refers to given information. In other words, we're given that we have two lines cut by a transversal and alternate interior angles are congruent. The conclusion of the if-then statement is what it is we're trying to prove. We want to prove that lines are parallel. So let's draw out the given information. So here we have two lines cut by a transversal. Let's call one of the lines M, N, and we could call the transversal T. Now our job is to show that alternate interior angles are congruent. But which are the alternate interior angles? So the alternate interior angles could refer to, let's say, this angle and this angle, those two blue angles. It could also refer to these two green angles. Now, for sake of argument, we only need to pick one of the angle pairs. So I think I'll pick the blue angles. So we're given that those two angles are congruent. It'd be easier if I could just name the angles. Let's call this angle 1 and angle 2. So we know that angles 1 and angle 2 are congruent. Now, as it stands right now, angles 1 and angle 2 are congruent. The only way that we can prove lines are parallel are with corresponding angles. So corresponding angles, take a look at angle 1. Angle 1 and its vertical angle, let's call this angle 3. I know that angles 1 and 3 are congruent because vertical angles are always congruent. So now we know angles 1 and 3 are congruent because 1 and 3 are vertical angles. So if 1 is congruent to 2, and 1 and 3 are also congruent, then we can say that angles 2 and 3 are also congruent. So 2 and 3 form corresponding angles, and corresponding angles will allow us to say that the lines are indeed parallel. So that's kind of the general idea of the proof. Now let's put it together in a rigorous proof. So let's restate the given and prove information in terms of our diagram. So we're given 1 and 2 are congruent. In other words, alternate interior angles are congruent, and our job is to prove that M and N are parallel. Angles 1 and angle 2 are congruent, and we know that's true because it's given information. That's the hypothesis of the conditional statement. Also, we know that, angles 1 and 3? Yeah, angles 1 and 3 are vertical angles. So we'll want to mention that fact and then state that vertical angles are always congruent. So angles 1 and 2, oh, that's a typo. They're not angles 1 and 2. Angles 1 and 3 are vertical angles, which means angles 1 and 3 are congruent. Let's erase. Angles 1 and 3 are vertical angles, and therefore vertical angles are congruent. Now, 1 and 2 are congruent, as shown in the blue. 1 and 3 are congruent, as shown in the green. So the blues and the greens can come together. If 1 is 2 and 1 is 3, then 2 and 3 are congruent. So angle 2 is congruent to angle 3. So 2 and 3 are congruent by the transitive property, right? We can bring together the blue and the green. And if 2 and 3 are congruent, 2 and 3 are corresponding angles, and corresponding congruent angles always make parallel lines. So that last box we can fill in would be that M and N are parallel. And why is that true? It's true because if we have corresponding angles that are congruent, then the lines are parallel.